Kandata says, Master Woolghit, wait.
Uh-oh.
Wait. These guys came for that girl. That means... Badat says, oh no, it's Kandata. Show us your faces, Kandata says. Whoa. He took the veils off Yurio and Badat. I remember you. They must be working for the Desert Panther. They were at my house when it was destroyed. Really? Says Woolghit. Yurio says, it's a misunderstanding. Badat says, we don't know anything about the Desert Panther. Kandata says, your denials make me more suspicious. I ordered my men to make you fight at the Colosseum. How did you get here? Woolghit says, it doesn't matter. So you're working for the Desert Panther, that detestable wench who plots against me? I will never let you go. Soldiers, arrest them. Lock them up and assign a guard. Oh no, says Badat. Yurio says, we were so close. Crap. Badat says, that bastard Kandata ruined everything. Wow. Strong words there. Yurio says, what are we going to do? Oh, that's that room we couldn't open. Is there any exit? Badat says, check the door first. It's an iron door. It's locked. Badat says, even I can't take it down. You must think of some way to destroy it. Let's check the walls. We might find a weak section we can break through. Well, there's like windows here, and we just break the wood there? Right, says Badat says, let's check. Do you know what you call this kind of situation? Go for wool and come home shorn. Yurio says, okay, so someone was shaved. I'm sorry? You don't get it, do you? Not at all. Forget it. Let's check the walls. This section of the wall is made of wood. Maybe you can break it if you hurl your body into it. Badat says, who would do such a thing? Why are you looking at me like that? I can try, but we must do it fast. If we delay even a little, we'll be caught right away. I wish we had a bomb or something. I don't think my body is powerful enough to break it. I hope someone will come and rescue us. Yurio says, actually, we are the ones who came to do the rescuing. Well, hopefully our friend shows up. I came to rescue you. It's her, aka the Desert Panther, aka whatever her name is. What? Says Yurio. Is this happening? Badat says. Please be quiet. I'll destroy the wall. Once it's down, follow me quickly. Okay, says Yurio. Are you ready? Yes, says Yurio. Let's go. Oh, wow. What was that? Says Woolghit. Kandata says, maybe it's the Desert Panther. Get her, Woolghit says. She's the Desert Panther. You still have to rescue Chris, though. Well, there's Peja. She says, come inside quickly. Thanks, says a Desert Panther. What's her name again? With the green hair? Yeah, you can tell it's her. Soldier says, hey, Peja, have you seen anyone suspicious coming this way? No, I haven't seen anyone. All right. I'll look somewhere else then. Huh. Sucker born every minute. Chris says, what happened? I can't see what's going on outside because this stupid room has no window. Are you there? The soldier says, what? Be quiet. What happened? I heard a big bang. Oh, that. Some guys came to rescue a friend who was going to be forced to be a dancer. They obviously failed and got captured themselves. He doesn't know that person is Chris? Chris says, I see. How stupid. But guess what happened? The Desert Panther rescued them. What you heard was the explosion from the bomb the Desert Panther set. Chris says, the Desert Panther again. By the way, the soldier says, isn't it you? The friend who going to be forced to be a dancer? What? Yeah, that's right. It's me. Then the men who came to rescue me must be... Yurio? Oh no. You came all the way here only to get caught. You're so helpless. Yurio can't do anything right without me. The soldier says, may I say something? I think you got it wrong. You were captured first. That's why your friends came to rescue you. If you hadn't been caught, they wouldn't have come here. Don't blame your friends. I feel sorry for them. Shut up, Chris yells. Oops. I don't want Woolghit's minion preaching at me. Oh my. Please don't say that. That's funny. Yurio says, thank you. You saved us. Badat says, I appreciate your help, but we've been suffering many misfortunes because of you. It's all your fault. I'm sorry. The Desert Panther took off her mask and... No surprise. It's... What's her name? Badat says, oh. Yurio says, what the... Najee, Badat says. That's her name. Najee, you were the Desert Panther? Oh, God. You guys are clueless. I didn't mean to cause you trouble. I'm sorry. Badat says, I didn't know. It doesn't matter, then. Sorry for my harsh words. Yurio says, how come it doesn't matter that it was Najee? Because I said so. Just forget it. The Panther says, this country is ruled by Woolghits, who does as he pleases. Everyone thinks we should do something, but thinking alone doesn't solve anything. We must stand up against the lawlessness brought by the wealthy merchants. We have supporters like Peja and Godona. I became the Desert Panther to fight on behalf of the people. I see, says Badat. It's a good story. I'll give you a hand. The Desert Panther nodded, visibly pleased. Najee is an alias I use to hide my identity. My identify. From the officials. My real name is Stella. How many names do you have? That's exactly what I was thinking. Badat says, Najee, Desert Panther, and now Stella. Stella, how many names do you have? Call me Stella from now on. It's my real name. All right, says Yurio. Woolghit is distracted because of the explosion. I'll help you too. Now is our chance. Let's resume the rescue mission to save Chris. Yurio says, the room she's trapped in has an iron door and stone walls. You can't blow them up with your bombs. I've checked the room already, Stella says. That room has an outside door and an inside door. The outside door is made of iron, but the inside door is a regular wooden door. As long as we can open the iron door, I can blow up the inside door. Okay, says Badat. Is there any way we can open the iron door? If we create a diversion outside the mansion one more time, the guards inside will come out. Create a diversion? Says Yurio. I'll blow up this shack. This shack? Says Badat. Yes. Seeing this place blow up, the soldiers come to investigate. You're right, says Badat. This shack is far enough away from the mansion, so it is a good place to attract the soldiers' attention. Woolghit and his soldiers are on high alert because of the previous explosion. I'm sure they'll come running here en masse. Yurio says, Stella, you're smart. I'll blow this place up. Yurio, take these. Stella handed some bombs to Yurio. Sweet. Use them to destroy the inside door. Okay. Be careful. Don't get caught by the soldiers. Yurio says, we'll be okay. Alright, Badat says, let's begin our operation. Chris says, what are you doing, Yurio? If you got away, come and rescue me quickly. You're so slow. He can't hear you. Here he comes. Phew, Yurio says, we managed to get here. Badat says, Stella will blow up the shack any minute. Stella says, yeah! Badat says, let's go. Go to the shack, Yurio says. Oh, he's willing them to go to the shack. Soldier says another explosion? As we suspected, Desert Panther was hiding nearby. We must go and look for her too. We have no choice. If Master Woolghit learns later that we didn't help search, we'll be in big trouble. Yo-Yo says, yes, everything is going according to our plan. Let's go, says Bat-At. Alright, so they left it unlocked, and we plant a bomb. Da-boom-da-boom, to blow up this door. Yo-Yo says, Chris. Are you there, Chris? Yo-Yo? What took you so long? I'm sorry. Bat-At says, what are you apologizing for? You came to rescue her. Yeah, that's right. I shouldn't be apologizing. What are you babbling about? Chris says. Get me out of here, quickly. Oh, all right. We're blowing up this door, so step back. Okay. I'm ready. Yo-Yo set the bomb. Do you think this is correct? Am I doing it right? Don't ask me, says Bat-At. Hey, you've already lit the fuse. I think we should run, too. Wow, the fuse is burning so fast, says Yo-Yo. It's gonna blow, Bat-At says. Let's go, step back. Woohoo, says Yo-Yo. Quick, Yo-Yo, the soldiers heard the sound. They'll come back soon. Right. Chris, Yo-Yo. Bat-At says, hurry, let's get out of here. We can say each other's names later. Who is he, by the way, says Chris. I'll tell you later. Chris joins the party. Yay! Bat-At says, let's go. Oh, here's Woolghit. I saw through your plan. Ack, says Yo-Yo. Damn, it's Woolghit, says Bat-At. Says. The soldiers went out to search for the Desert Panther, but I stayed here because I knew you would show up. Ha ha ha. You fell into my trap. What a nasty guy, says Bat-At. Let's beat him up, says Chris. Yeah, I want my Crimson Fire back, too. Did you give him the Crimson Fire? Says Chris. I had no choice. He said he wouldn't do us a favor unless we gave him something rare. Woolghit's laughing. Take it from me if you can. I entered into a contract with Revas. No ordinary man can defeat me. Revas? Chris asks. Yo-Yo says, I've heard that name somewhere. Look, I'm pumped up and ready to go. Oh, boy. Woolghit has a roaring voice. Bat-At says, wow, he looks formidable. Prepare to die. Oh, no, says Yo-Yo. We're trying to run. Oh, but there's Kandata. Bat-At says, it's Kandata. Yo-Yo says, we're surrounded. Estella says, the soldiers should be here any minute. Soldier says, oh, look, this place is gone, too. It's been blown to pieces. They must be still around here. Let's search the area. Yo-Yo says, we're sandwiched. You can't escape now, says Kandata. Oh, it won't stop us from trying. Woolghit's laughing. You can't go anywhere. Nice! Woolghit says, eh? Stella says, this way, please. Thank you, says Yo-Yo. Kandata says, you threw a bomb at me without warning. You're so heartless. Of course, bombs won't even scratch me. Feel the power of Master Revas. So he and me had a deal with Revas, too? Or he is Revas? Bat-At says, what are these guys? Yeah, exactly. Stella says, I think Woolghit and Kandata are no ordinary humans. Bat-At says, he said something about entering into a contract with Revas. Revas? Stella says. Revas the astrologer in Folthia? Yo-Yo says, I see. I knew I heard the name somewhere. Bat-At says, anyway, we have no choice but to fight. Yo-Yo and the party prepare to fight. Bat-At says, Yo-Yo, you take care of him. Okay. We're throwing bombs. This is unusual fight. Nice. Badat says, what kind of creatures are they? Stella says, I hear Revas, the astrologer in Fulthia, uses uncanny spells. I believe Woolghit and Kandata have gained monstrous power by using Revas's spells. Is that possible? Says Yurio. Yes, it's possible if a master of evil spells uses the knowledge of astrology. Badat says, why do you know so much? Chris says, hey, he's still alive. Ugh, says Woolghit. Oh, and they're both still alive. Kandata says, arg. Dang it, Badat says. Why don't you just die? Wait, something's different, says Chris. What? I think they've returned to their normal selves. Something was probably controlling their mind. I don't feel the evil in them anymore. I didn't know you could feel something like that. Yo-Yo says, yeah, I agree. Badat says, then I have no choice. We should stop beating them up. Alright, let me revive them. Yeah, says Badat. Because that wakes him up. Woolghit says, ouch. Ow. Huh? What am I doing here? I feel refreshed, but I have some aches in my back. Badat says, yeah, again. Kandata says, ow. Woo, I feel great. Hmm? What happened to me? Chris says, I think they're conscious now. No kidding, they're up and they're talking. Of course they're conscious. The soldier says, Master Woolghit! Master Kandata! Woolghit says, ouch. My mind is clear, but every part of my body aches. Please take me to my bed. Right away, sir. The evil power that was controlling the minds of Woolghit and Kandata was lifted. The intense fight with Yurio and his party apparently caused the power to leave. The soldiers learned of what happened and promptly carried Woolghit and Kandata into the mansion. Woolghit says, whew, I feel better now. It may sound strange, but I think my mind was paralyzed. Kandata says, Master Woolghit, I feel the same. Revas must have done this to us. Right, he must have. Yo-Yo says, can you tell me more about it? Alright, says Kandata. About 6 months ago, when I came here to buy some goods, I dropped by the mansion to say hello to Master Woolghit. At the same time, Revas, the astrologer from Fulthia, showed up. Woolghit says, I had heard of him too. At that time, he asked to meet with me, Fulthia's official ambassador. He wanted to talk about... Well, I remember a shiver running down my back when he first talked to me. But when I saw his eyes, all my intention to resist mysteriously disappeared. He asked Godona to ally with Fulthia and help them prepare to invade the world. Badat says they wanted to make sure their neighbor was on their side. Yo-Yo asks, but how can they... Chris says, invade the world? There's no way our country would dream up such a heinous plot. Woolghit says, I'm sorry, but his wicked glowing red eyes were real. Revas promised he would leave Godona alone on the condition that we became their ally. He also told me I would be in charge of all trading once the world became theirs. Pagia says, the red eyes. Those with the seed of greed will soon lose sight of their heart. A man with red eyes will invite trouble. Oh, is that another Moonlight Witch thing? My late grandmother said that to me. She said it was a prophecy by the Moonlight Witch. The Moonlight Witch? Yo-Yo says. Chris says, I didn't know there was such a legend in this country. It's not widely known like folklore. The Moonlight Witch only said that to my grandmother, whom she befriended here 20 years ago. My grandmother told me the Moonlight Witch was in a great hurry. In a hurry? Says Yo-Yo. Was she going somewhere? Says Chris. My grandmother told me she headed to Fulthia. The Moonlight Witch told her to watch out for the red eyes. Do not be misled by red eyes. She also said that when a man with red eyes appeared, an evil plan would be in the works. That's all I know. Badat says, Yo-Yo, why are you so interested in the Moonlight Witch? Well, just a little. He says, your face is telling me there's something more. Why don't you tell me everything? I may be able to help you. Hmm, says Yo-Yo. Yo-Yo, what do you think? I think we should tell them so Godona won't be involved in Ravas's plan. I agree, says Yurio. Mr. Woolghit, you listen carefully, too. All right, go ahead. We came from Folthia, says Yurio. We completed our pilgrimage to visit the shrines of the world. It's a custom of our small village in Folthia. We're on our way back. Oh, so you're pilgrims. Badat says, I didn't know that. We saw a very ominous image in the magic mirror in Oldos, our final destination. You may know that the magic mirrors in the shrines have the powers to show things that could happen in the future. Chris says, the magic mirror showed us an image of Castle Rudo preparing for a war. Any soldiers gathered in the courtyard, and we saw a suspicious-looking man wearing a robe. Yo-Yo says, it was probably Ravas. Badat says, in other words, things are happening exactly as Yo-Yo and Chris saw in the mirror in Oldos. That's right, says Yo-Yo. Chris says, one more thing. As we traveled, we heard stories about the Moonlight Witch. Yo-Yo says, when we put those stories together, we came to the conclusion that the Moonlight Witch must have foretold what would happen in Folthia. Really? Says Peja. Yo-Yo and Chris told them about what they had learned. They also explained the connections between the Moonlight Witch and the images they saw in the magic mirrors. They didn't talk about the rave of Rarual, but the information they gave was enough for others to grasp the seriousness of the matter. Woolghit says, I didn't know. Now that we are combining the story Peja heard from her grandmother, it looks like I almost became part of Revas's plan. Oh, says Kandata. What is it, says Woolghit. Master Woolghit, since Revas's visit, we have been letting the Folthia army guard our border with Folthia. What? Dang it, says Woolghit. What should we do? We must do something at once. Kandata says, if we're not lucky, the Folthia army may have taken control of the Folthia border already. How careless of me, says Woolghit. I was hypnotized by his red eyes and wasn't thinking straight. We must leave at once. Gather the soldiers. I'm sending the entire army to the Folthia border. Stella says, that won't work. Woolghit says, you? The Desert Panther? She says, there's no way your soldiers can defeat Folthia if they've built up some serious military strength. There's only one way to stop the plan. We must sneak into Castle Rudo and take down the mastermind. Yurio says, I agree. This is probably our role. Our country is about to make a mistake. Chris says, right. We can't turn a blind eye to the evil deed which is going to bring disaster to the world. Badat says, I'll come with you. I've been training for myself for situations like this. Really, Badat? Thank you. You're worth 100 soldiers, says Yurio. Of course I'm coming too, says Stella. Stella, says Yurio. Now that Woolghit and Kandata have finally come to their senses, Godona will be fine. But if Folthia invades us, the whole world will be thrown into chaos. We must prevent it at any cost. Thank you, Stella, says Chris. Stella joins the party. Sweet. Yurio says, Master Woolghit, please don't send your soldiers to the border. Badat says, I understand. I also think we shouldn't let Ravas know I was released from his hypnosis. Okay, that's not Badat. Woolghit should be saying that. Stella says, but you can't continue to be a tyrant to the people like before. All right. I'll do whatever you tell me to do. We cannot do business if there are no customers. I know that very well. So please stop Ravas's plan and return the world to a place where we can do business safely. Kandata says, I'm serious. Please. Chris says, they're still talking about business. I wonder if they've really reformed. Badat says, they are natural businessmen. They can't help it. But they've learned that something bad is happening. I'm sure they won't continue their crooked practices. Woolghit says, oh, I almost forgot. I'll return this to you. Please take it. Oh, the fire thing? Woolghit took out crimson fire from inside his jacket. Yurio got crimson fire back. Stella says, let's head for the border now. We don't have much time. First, we'll talk to people. What's his name? Kandata? He says, I'll help make Godona a better place to live. I'll also make sure Ravas won't find out. I'll close down the Colosseum in Baraka immediately. So please, let us continue our business in peace. Take care of Folthia. Pasia? I'm so glad. Godona will become a better place now. I'm happy to serve Master Woolghit now that he's a changed man. I'll do my share for the happiness of Godona. Talk to Woolghit. Business requires greed to a certain extent, but Ravas used my greed to his advantage and controlled my mind. Too strong of an enterprising spirit is bad. I learned that very well. From now on, I'll conduct my business by thinking what's best for my people. So please, please save this country from the threats of Folthia. Do that for the other people in the world, too. Who are these people? Is old? I like men in desert who are a bit selfish. I like men in desert who are a bit selfish, okay? Vivian says, Master Woolghit will be a kind man from now on. Okay. I think we also had a spell on us, but don't worry, we're fine now. Should Master Woolghit fall for an evil spell again, we'll bring him back to his senses. Who in the world is Ravas of Folthia? That's a long story. I want to take... Yeah, I want to sit on the throne. Pass me the grapes. I'm sorry. Master Woolghit has been so full of himself lately. I knew something was wrong. Well, please keep it between you and me. I had no intention of doing any harm. By the way, you're not a dancer type. Chris says, what's that supposed to mean? You're saying I can't dance? No, no, that's not what I mean. Anyway, please forgive me. Her handiwork here. Anyone else to talk to around here? That's where Pasia was. She's over in the main chamber now. And then there's these people. You must have heard a really loud boom. Hey, I hear Master Woolghit and Kandata have completely reformed. I don't know how it happened, but that's good news for the residents of Godona. If it's a dream, I don't want to wake up. It's not a dream, it's real. I don't think things will change immediately, but Godona will surely become a better place to live. It will, but don't call me Shirley. Hey, you! You can go ahead and enter now. Go ahead, you may enter. Oh, we're leaving. I wish Master Woolghit cared more about us. Well, he cares a little bit more now. At least he claims to. Nothing new there. Phew! Oh, yeah. Read that before. I can be rich if I have a lot of figs. No, wait. If I have a lot, then the price would come down, right? It's always difficult to buy the right amount. Hi there, young man. We don't have any figs, but you can find a variety of other things. Why don't you take a peek? No, I will not. Oh, let's check out what she has. Stella. Stella has 245 hit points. And 141 magic. She is currently wearing or using a blue pearl rod. Let me get like info on that. Wait. Wisdom robes and an archer's cape. Okay, we can give her. A magic ring? Does she use magic? Find out in a second. Oh, she has chapel magic. Oh, just the basic cures. And canned magic. She's got a good amount of elemental type spells. Silver bullet as well. Attacks enemies in a large area with a volley of magical projectiles. Gaia Fall. Conjures a large rock and drops it on the enemy. Someone had that a while ago. Freeze Lance. Collects water from the air and drops it on the enemy. Flame Burst. Burns the enemies with a whirlwind of fire. Speed up. Attack up. Speed down. Panic. I've seen those. And Time Stop. Stop time for all enemies and friends, excluding the caster. Huh. That's interesting. 50 magic points to use that. Finishing move, she has magic burst. And skill, she has grenade. Attacks enemies with a grenade. Sweet. Oh, yeah. See if there's anything she can make use of. Ooh. Sorcerer staff is a lot better. 3,800. We'll get that for Stella. No one else can use the shield. Fleeting robes are a step down for Stella. Okay. Okay, so her attack goes from 148 to 152, and her magic attack goes from 179 to 193. Sweet. I just want to look at this. Weapons. The blue pearl used for this rod contains ancient, powerful magic. Well, we don't need it anymore. What sword is he using? Let's sell this blue pearl rod. It was cheap. He's using Ancient Sword. Yeah, I'm gonna sell the Master Sword. That fetched a pretty price. We're done in here. Really? Did you see Woolghit? He is a changed man? I don't believe it. Of course, if it's true, I can't be happier. Let's wait and see if Woolghit truly has reformed. Let's. You just sell canned stuff? Yeah, or pet food? I don't think anyone needs any rest. Don't need that. Okay, so the other way out is this way, I think. Stella says, we must hurry. I want to know what's happening at the Fothia border. Okay, well, you're stopping us from continuing. Gwil Road. South Gadonal behind us, 52 milos, and north is the Dilt Checkpoint. 957 Milos. And that'll be next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure. I'm trying to end the episode here.